set us free to be more fully who you created us to be.
Rejoice, friends, and believe in the good news of the gospel. In Jesus Christ,
we are forgiven.
Because God has forgiven us in Christ. We are called, we are beckoned to forgive one another again and again and again. So may the peace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with you all. And let us physically distance, but never spiritually, let us extend the peace of Christ to one another.
Our new communications guy came out from Oklahoma, then we had COVID, and welcome to Nashville. Also, real quick announcement, those signs, someone has donated, or a number of people have donated Living Out the Word signs for people who want them in their yard, and so if you'd like one, we're asking for a $20 donation for Habitat. And you can do it no touch, just put a $20 bill in a bucket and take one home with you and stick it in the yard and then put it next to your political candidate so everybody knows. Yeah. I have seen that, so it's interesting. All right. Let's pray. Gracious and holy God, we give you thanks and praise that we are able to gather today on this day that you have made. And to hear your word once again. Open our hearts to it, open our lives to it, so that we might do your work, the agents of your will. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. You have a bulletin. Why don't you read it with me? It's Psalm 100. Make a joyful noise to the Lord, all the earth.
Worship the Lord with gladness. Come into his presence with singing. Know that the Lord is God. It is he that made us, and we are his. We are his people, and the sheep of his pasture. Enter his gates with thanksgiving, and his courts with praise. Give thanks to him. Bless his name. For the Lord is good. His steadfast love endures forever, and his faithfulness to all generations.
Amen. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Make a joyful noise. Make a joyful noise to the Lord, all the earth. Make a joyful noise to the Lord, all the earth. All the earth. Praise God. I've got real people in front of me. God, I miss you. Lord knows I have missed all of you. Praise be to God, and we just made a joyful noise to the Lord, all the earth. This time has changed us all. It has changed me. You probably have noticed I have allowed my hair to go gray. Thank you very much. Well, you don't get that in an empty tree. You don't get the heckling either. So, you know, I've given up being an introvert during this time. I'm ready to embrace extroversion. I'm all about people now. You know, 6 months ago, if you asked me to preach in a pulpit in a parking lot, I would have said, no, I am too good for that. But now I am embracing it wholeheartedly. I do parking lot preaching, and I'm just happy that we can do what our sign says outside. Westminster gathering. You know, I've driven my car up here, and I've driven my bike up here to a perfectly beautiful empty building. basketball court for about 3 or 4 months. It's been remarkable. You should see my jump shot. But man, it's been kind of awful not having you here, not having this building filled with people. And you realize right away that the church is not a building, but it is a people. And it is so good to see you. Worship the Lord with gladness. I suspect that the gladness department has been a little short-ended the year in 2020. Not a lot of gladness being offered up in 2020. And so it says, worship the Lord with gladness. And so what I want you to do is just smile behind that mask and give God some gladness. God, smile. Don't strain anything. We haven't used it in a while. Give God some gladness. I chose this song because I needed to exercise some joy. Because make a joyful noise. Worship the Lord with gladness. Come into His presence with singing. Make worship come. Make worship come. Make worship come. Exercising our faith. We have spent so much attention on ourselves, it feels like that's how miserable things have been. Telling each other about our miseries, but let's just give our attention just a bit, this afternoon to God. I want you to take a COVID-free breath and exhale your praise to God. Breathe in. Think about the love you receive from your friends. Feel that love that you receive from your friends. Take a deep breath and think about the amazing life that God has given you. All the days that you've had so far. Breathe it in. Exhale and say, thank you, God. Go ahead. Say, thank you, God. Amen. Know that the Lord is God. Know that the Lord is God of your relationships. The Lord of God is God of your family and friends. Know that the Lord is God in the midst of a pandemic. Know that the Lord is God in your worries. He can give you comfort. That the Lord is God as you parent kids in a time when no parent has ever had to parent kids like this before. Know that the Lord is God as a rock in all your insecurities. Know that the Lord is God in this day. Know that the Lord your God is in your heart. Know that the Lord your God is in your praise. The Lord God has made us. The Lord God has made us, and we are God's people. I want you to do me a favor right now. I want you to just take a look at your feet. Isn't that an odd thing? The only reason I'm telling you to do this is because I had an epiphany when I was probably about 4 years old, and I can still see it. I'm in my back yard in West Des Moines, Iowa, playing with my little yellow Tonka trucks. And I happened to look at my hand, and I still remember it to this day. And just looking at my hand and thinking, that's a cool thing. You know? I mean, look at it. Just look at your hand and just think of all the intricacies that your brain can tell your hand to move fingers. Here's one for the kids. Oh, my gosh. Thank you. I'll be here on the tip jars over there. Look at your hand. See how marvelous it is, just the hand. God has made us. God has made us. And it longs these days. I think the hand longs these days make mistakes, so give yourself a breath. Remembrance that God does not make mistakes. We are God's people. Enter his gates with thanksgiving and his courts with praise. This week I received 2 emails about 20 seconds apart. The first one I received was an email from someone in this congregation who lost a friend to suicide. Many of you may have known that person. And moments after that email, I received an email from a member of our congregation who's fighting cancer, going into chemo, wanting to live more days. And she wrote to her friend this note: keep appreciating the small things that mean something to you. Make them sacred. Keep close to your family and friends in whatever ways you can in 2020. Fall is my favorite time of year. Here's hoping for some good cover in the trees and a pumpkin on the floor. So it is that I feel she has eyes for Thanksgiving. Just look at the colors out here, even on a gray day. Greens. Look at the colors of the people. Look at the colors of your life. And be thankful. The Lord is good. His steadfast love endures forever, his faithfulness to all generations. It is good that the rain has ended on this day. I am thankful that we can all gather here. It is good to be alive. It is good to see you all and to give God thanks and praise. So make a joyful noise to the Lord all the earth. Amen.
Thank you.
lift up our prayer. For those suffering in the West in the fires.
For all those suffering in the West in the fires, God.
We lift up our prayer.
You, O God, we never contain you, and we thank you.